Hello, I'm Matthias Carstens from RME, and I want to talk about the new Babyface Pro. You can see here, this unit is not an improved old Babyface. It's completely re-engineered, not remastered. It's our current slogan for the unit, to show that it's everything is redone. There's nothing from taken over from the old Babyface. That includes the housing, the way it's to be operated, the in and outs, the electronic circuits inside, the ADAT conversion, the whole concept inside. It's very familiar as desktop interface, it's easy to use, but so many details changed. We will not have the time to talk about all of them, but some. Yeah, let's start with the outside of the unit. The housing is no longer die-cast, it's machined from a block of aluminum. Here on the back you can see the XLR I/O. We don't have an analog audio breakout cable anymore. The XLRs are built into the housing. And this is, you can see, not a normal design where you have just an XLR socket. This allowed us to make it more small and more thin. Here on this side you see two TS because now we have four analog inputs. So two microphone line and two line instrument here. These are up to 19 dBU. So full professional level. These are up to 13 dBU. Next to it are two headphone outputs. That is new too. We have one optimized for low impedance headphones. This one has an internal impedance or output impedance from 2 ohms. The other one is 10 ohms with 6 dB higher level, so it's optimized for more high ohm, high impedance headphones. So on the other side, you see the ADAT SPDIF optical I/O. There's one breakout cable included for MIDI I/O. This is a lockable DC connector. It's not included in external power supply, but if you want to use it standalone without USB power, you can plug in the normal standard power supplies, or you buy the special one from RME, which is even lockable. Yeah? And here the USB connector. This one is special too. Any standard USB cable fits in. But here, this one is included as well. It's a special one. It's 90 degree and it has a special rim going around. If you plug it in slowly, you will see how it fits into the housing. There's no wiggling, it's fully stable and it looks perfectly. So we were able to improve the whole operating and the surface here by adding two more level meter bars and having four dedicated keys to steer all the necessary operations. So for example, the out key is quite easy to understand. You select any of the outputs that you have. Channel 1, 2, 3, 4 is phones and optical. It is SPDIF. And then when you turn the wheel, your output volume will change. Quite logical. You can see the same here in total mix where it goes up and down. So now something can happen. You get too much level overload and you change to 3-4. Usually you would not see anymore that your other channel is overloading. But here the LED from the channel itself turns into red to show that. Yeah, you can see now. We just had a change in the music. Yeah? So now the second one comes red too. So there's no bad surprise anymore. The same is true for the inputs with the gain and everything. Next improvement is in the input side itself. I cannot show this here now because we don't have an input signal. Gain and input level is shown at the same time. So if you raise the input gain from the microphones, for example, select left, right, like this. Here you see only the gain at this time. If you have music coming in, you will see the music as well. So you can clearly see how much you have to turn up until it overloads. It's very easy to see and to use. At the same time, you don't lose overview because while you adjust your gain here, you still see the output working. Now, some of the operation is similar to the old Babyface because if you go to one of the input channels, you can select between left, right, or both channels with this button. Yeah? Quite easy. the unit will always remember these settings. So if you change to a different one and you turn the button, so I have now here stereo mode. I go back to 1-2 and you will see it's immediately in stereo mode. Yeah? Same here. So easy to use. New is also this mix button, something that people always wanted to have, I think. You see, we are going into input currently into input 3-4 now, and we go out from channel 1-2. So if I hit the mix button now, I can select one or two or both, and then just turn up my monitoring volume. That is the same that you see in Total Mix, because it's a synchronized view. So in Total Mix, not only the fader will go up and down, but also the output, the submix view will change. It's very easy to understand and to use. This is really catered for the typical one-person producer, engineer, musician. Microphone in the front, guitar on his knee, headphone on, and you just want to quickly grab the unit and change his monitoring level from one of the inputs. He can do this now. You don't have to use the mouse with Total Mix anymore. At the same time, all this functionality is there for standalone mode. So in standalone mode, you can do the same. Maybe you know the old application example from the old Babyface microphone preamp. For that, you had to make a digital loop. Digital output, digital input. No longer necessary, because you can directly route the input to any output. So, for the standalone mode, it's also interesting to see that if you push the set button for 2 seconds, you go into the configuration mode, and then with select, you just step through all the options. Auto-sync, internal, different sample rates, stuff like that. Just to give you another example of how easy to understand and how logical this kind of operating surface is, if we push 3 times here, we go to the optical output. This optical output can be a SPDIF or ADAT optical. So how to switch between these two? You just go to set, you see 2 LEDs, that means it's a SPDIF, stereo. And now you select to ADAT, you get 8 LEDs. This is something you don't have to read in the menu. You want to set the output and you want to select which mode. So it's that easy. We are now in standalone mode here. We just have a power supply connected. And like the old Babyface, you are able to change to class compliant mode for use with the iPad and stuff like that. So you just push select and dim. And you see it's CC on the display. Now the fine thing is that every time you turn it on, you will be remember that it's in CC mode, because it will show exactly that. And coming back to the normal mode is PC indication then.